So I actually started school right out of high school in 2011 doing interior design. So I went to school for a year for that and I hated it. I had to memorize hundreds of fabrics and things like that and it wasn't what I thought it was going to be. So I actually took a year off to get my cosmetology license, so I still do hair here and there. Worked in a salon for 4 years, but when I went back to school a year later, I went back for graphic design because it was more geared toward what I kind of was expecting. So typically when I get the email and they've kind of laid out what they wanted, I'll ask them first off their deadline. I need to know how much time I have to do it. Typically I try to get breweries labels back within a week or so. And then I'll ask them if it's a new client, I'll ask them if they have specific colors that they want to have incorporated, because some bigger brands have kind of specifications on what colors they use. Like Two Toms has a blue and a green that is true to their logo. And that's another thing, I'll make sure I have a high quality file of their logo that I can work with too. I need to know like the ABV and the IBU and if they want to add a description on the label. It is actually really nice when I have direction because I don't know about everybody else, but it's my worst nightmare to hear, you know, surprise me or like do whatever you want, because when that happens, most of the time you'll spend all your time doing it, send it, and they're like, well, that's not what I was thinking. And you'll have to start over, which is pretty common, honestly, and you get used to it, but direction is really, really nice to have, because you can just expand upon their idea and what they're looking for. I'm really bad about sketching things out. I personally feel like it's a waste of time, which a lot of artists are gonna be like, what the heck, because that's really crucial to a lot of people, which it is an important step, but like my version of that, I guess, is making more sort of a mood board in Illustrator, some like inspiration that I have found for the types of layout I like. And then one of the first things I do is find the color palette I want to use. So whether it's what the brewery has sent me as like a picture of reference or something that has to do with the theme of the beer, I'll, you know, find that online and then pick some colors out of that and get my like, you know, four squares and then get all those picked out so that I can be consistent and pick from those throughout the whole label. Typically open an old label that I've done before and erase everything, erase all the art. In Tom's case, I'll keep like the logo, the government warning and how everything's laid out, and I'll delete everything else so that all stays in the same spot on every label and it's consistent. And make sure the label's the correct size for print and everything like that. So that's how I start, and then I just kind of go at it. Usually I'll draw like the main element, like for instance, Cooper, which is Tom's little dog that just was on the beer, Cooper. I will get the main element drawn first and then kind of like get the rest of the design based around that. And that brings up another point. If a client wants something like really detailed or more lifelike, not so vectory or something like that, my husband will actually draw it, and then I will switch it to vector and put it on the label. So he helps out a lot with that. I make sure that they have the printer quality files, the Illustrator files. A lot of clients prefer that I work with the printer because I kind of know all the language that they're needing and things like that. They'll just tell me the quantity that they need and then I'll kind of go from there with the order for them so they don't have to worry about it. I always include social media mock-ups. Sometimes they have to remind me, but yeah, I will always give them a mock-up on a can so that they can kind of hype the beer up before it's released. So sometimes I will take some really nice stylized photos of the beer either before it's released or kind of in the middle. If we have some left for people to buy, we can use it as an extra hype to get the rest of the cases sold. So Yeah, I'll just kind of do a themed shot. I try to do some fun stuff, like if the beer has a lot of different flavors in it, for instance, Lost in the Dark Bananas Foster has bananas, pecans, chocolate. So I'll really get that all styled together, maybe bring my husband in to drizzle some chocolate while I take some shots. I try to do maybe short little gifts too, just some fun different ways to get people excited about the beer.